chance to build too many condemned buildings, but this one hasn't got air conditioning, so we're going to sweat tonight. Well, we did one of these just recently in Toronto, and I didn't have air conditioning either. So, I said that if anybody wanted to take their clothes off, they'd be very welcome. I added a bra and a sock and a hat to my collection, so if anybody wants to add to that collection tonight, feel free to donate. Tonight, so get comfortable. We're going to carry on. You'll park my back, but I can't talk to anybody at once. It's a song. A song from Wind and Wuthering. Go easy on the hard ones, because if I hit somebody, you know, mind you, I wouldn't mind the other one of these. These are fitting. This is called One for the Vine.
I'm still here.
have your attention, please, whilst I tell you the short story. Now, this next part of our show tells the story of a friend of ours. His name was Albert. And Albert was a very unfortunate man. Everything he did went wrong. He was a born loser. I shall give you an example of this. He once fell in love with a lady. This is a lady. Yes, this is definitely a lady. Her name was the Duchess. The Duchess was very much in love with Albert, and Albert very much in love with the Duchess. But the Duchess was a very domineering lady, and so domineering was she that she was in fact into S&M. Now, this might sound like very exciting to you people, but Albert didn't speak Spanish or Mexican. So the Duchess kicked him out, a bit like that, and he went home that night, and Albert was very depressed, and so he sat on his sofa, and he opened a beer, and he turned on his television set. This is a television set. Yes, Albert sat watching his television, drinking his beer, and suddenly he was aware. Certainly he was aware that he was falling in love with his television set. And for a short while, Albert was very, very happy. Until he tried to make love to the television set. And then he was rushed to hospital to have the glass removed from his private parts. I think you know what I mean, I really do. Anyway, he rushed off to a vacation to get better, where Albert started to write music. And he wrote some wonderful music. Oh, he wrote such wonderful music like Selling Albert by the Pound. And then The Lamb Lies Down for Albert. Has got a new record out right now, which is called Duke. And so we thought it would be rather nice if we gave Albert's new record a plug. And so tonight we are going to play some music from Albert's new album called Duke. Thank you very much!
thank you. Again, having some fun with the phone. This is another very, 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 very short thing story. This one tells the story of two people. I shall tell you more about these two people. This is also your chance to participate in the entertainment. Now, this next song is all about a hero that we like and a villain that we don't like. I think some of you are getting the hang of it already. This one is a hero that we like. This one is a villain we don't like. One we like. One we don't like. We like. Lulu. You can see what kind of silliness this is going to be. This is the easy bit. Now for the hard bit. Every time I play the good guy, I don't do anything. But when I play the bad guy, I do this. So every time I do this, and that, I want everybody, and I mean everybody, because I have each and every one of yours own address, I want everybody to moo and kiss. Do you understand me? Right. We're going to have a little rehearsal, just so that all of us know what we're doing. Just the people not on the floor, just the people on the sides and the balconies, please, booing and kissing.
Up his short nose, around the monster,
Everybody enjoying themselves? Good. Then let's be kind to the guy that threw that thing over there. Then I'm gonna kick his ass. Anybody sees anybody throwing things, like dangerous type things? I want to know about it.
Yeah!
Meanwhile, don't let us not stop enjoying ourselves, eh? Well, while we're enjoying ourselves and you're enjoying yourselves, I'd like you to draw one special little moment, please, for our poor road crew. See, it's not because they work so hard, it is because they get so bored. They get so bloody bored. You see, nothing goes wrong, nothing falls over, nothing. Everyone's relatively sober. And so, we give them something to do. Yes, we let them play with two ladies on the bus. Then, when they get bored, we let them play with two men on the bus. Then, when they get bored, we let them play with each other and themselves on the bus. But they still get bored. So we let them play with the smoke machines. Now I know that you've only come to see our smoke machines. We're not paranoid or nothing, but I know that. We know that you've already come to see the smoke machines, and so I thought it would be a good idea if we watched the road crew play with the smoke machines.
That would be fun, wouldn't it?
So maybe if they finished with themselves in the crew bus, maybe they let us watch them playing with the smoke machines. So all we have to do is count to four, and maybe they let us watch them. Four,
two, three, four.
Hey, the smoke. Live from Buffalo tonight. The smoke machine. Say that we're going to be passing it round a little bit later. But it still doesn't smell as good as the stuff that I can smell out there. But they will let us play with that kind of thing, you know? Oh, no! My mother doesn't allow it. I dare not. It's called Ripples.
They've got a clue.
to take this brief opportunity to introduce to you a couple of our mates of ours who've been travelling around with us for the last 2 or 3 years. I don't know how many of you have seen them before. The last time we played in Buffalo, I know they were here. Will you welcome, please, on the guitar and on the bass guitar and at the rocky chop, Mr. Darren Sterler. Also from Los Angeles, in the blue corner representing the trans section, in the blue corner, Mr. Chester Thompson, on the ground.